Go.
Okay, welcome everybody. My name is Tiziana Margaria. I'm the course director of LM173 Immersive Software Engineering. So that means I'm the academic course director, but I'm also a co-director with Steven Kinsella of the entire program around with this, because ISC is an immersive bachelor master course, but it is actually more than that. It has a research component and several other components on top of that. Okay. My role in normal life is to be a software engineering professor here in UL in the Department of Computer Science and Information Systems. And additionally, I am a principal investigator in three research centers, national research centers, but we can talk about those later on. What I wanted to do today was to briefly present a couple of highlights concerning the LM173. We've been doing a lot of communication already before, basically meaning that some of you will already have seen our webinars. They will have seen some of the videos that we have published on our channel and also on the website, which is software-engineering.ie. Okay, so I just stay with a couple of highlights, and then we can have a long Q&A where we are asking whatever I forgot or whatever is interesting to you that you would like to have discussed more in depth. Okay, so welcome to this event, and I share my window for you. I have to go in presentation mode. Okay, how do I do that? Yeah. Okay. So, yes, it is a bachelor master, meaning that it is an integrated program. You start actually in semester one with the first cohort in the next September. And in 3.5 years, you achieve actually a master, so a level 9 qualification in immersive software engineering. A lot can be explained directly on the structure of the program. You see it here, how it is organized. Horizontally, you see the years, year 1, 2, 3, 4 going down, okay? And you see actually the development of the year on the left to right axis, okay? So you see that we are actually using 3 semesters. You are going to be with us in the autumn, in the spring, and also in the summer semester. That's why it is intensive, okay? And you're going actually to work in a different way. You're going to be immersed in on campus and in the companies. On campus, you're going to be with us in a studio-based environment, in dedicated space, working on projects, working on challenges, motivated by the needs of the current economy, society, and development. Working in groups or individually, okay? In a way that is much more integrative than what is practiced currently in the normal classrooms. You're not going to have a schedule, for example. You're going to be 9 to 6, Monday to Friday, with us, okay? Working with us and learning with us in what we call blocks. They correspond also to modules, but the important part is that, as you see in this scheme, every time, okay, every time you're going to do one thing. You don't have 5 modules that are going running in parallel with each other, doing different subjects like you know from school. You're going to work like people doing software engineering. They have projects, they are concentrated on projects, and whatever needs is needed to solve the project in the best way is actually what the team is doing. That's exactly how we are going to start with the first module, which is here. You see it, problem solving with computers. Even if you cannot program, that's not a problem. Computational thinking is important. We are going to think and learn to solve problems, organize problems, structure solutions, okay? Brainstorm and basically go through the process of moving from requirements to a deliverable system, so to say, together, so that you are going to learn the terminology, the mentality, the technology, the mathematics that you need, the programming that you need, everything integrated. We are going to do it for 4 different blocks, one after the other, 2 in the first semester. You see problem solving with computers and then effectively building software with others, which is in a certain sense the software life cycle from the requirements to the testing to the installation. And then in the second semester, we are going to have data-centric computing, and then computing and architectures 1 and 2. Okay, all these blocks are going to build upon what you have learned before, so that you are going to use and apply all the knowledge that you have gained in the previous blocks. What you see here in the summer is that you are going to have the first block of residency. Residencies are a concept of immersion in companies. Immersion in companies in a way that has a catalog of things that you have to try out and basically show that you can do. So these are full modules. They are not just internships where you're doing something and you're gaining experience, but there is no curriculum. These are actually embedded curricula in the companies in agreement with our partners, the residency partners. We are going to talk about them again. So you see that in semester three in the summer, you're going to be in a company the first time, much earlier than other students. You're going to spend the next semester in the second year in the autumn again in a residency. Then you're going to come back for one semester on campus, immersion on campus, in order to learn about human-centric computing and all the part that has to do with security, trust, privacy, and compliance, okay? And then you're going to go back for a residency and so on. So the back and forth is designed this way on purpose in order to have you experience and get the best of the two worlds, the education in groups with teachers, best teachers that we can have. We are hiring actually 8 people directly for the ISE program, exclusively for this one, and in the companies together with our partners, okay? What you see here is in green the bachelor part and in blue the master's part. So you see that at the end of the semester two of year three, you're going to move directly into the master. It is an integrated bachelor master, so you're going to progress actually with the master. You're going to have a module of research methods in the summer on campus, and then 2 modules about artificial intelligence and machine learning, that's of course important, and then software meets the world, which is basically applications of what you have learned so far and new technologies that are specific individually, so to say, to you. And then you're going to do your thesis actually in another residency. So it is a research project with 2 parts, part 1 and part 2, in a company, okay? You see, you're going to spend in this setting about half of your time in the companies. These are going to be different experiences from year 1 to year 4. Of course, you can imagine that you're going to do different things. You can also experience a different context from a large company to a small company. We have companies, you know, like Analog Devices, we have Stripe, we have Boston Scientific, we have Dell, we have Intel, etc. So there are large companies that are well known to everybody, but also there are some fantastic startups or near startups where you can learn a completely different way of doing things and of professing software engineering. For example, Trackworks, Soapbox, Provisor, Mana Aero, and so on. Okay, so you're going to have quite a portfolio of experience the moment you leave the program. Okay, so what are the scientific, what are the central traits actually of the course? Well, it is a computer science degree, full-size computer science degree, concentrated on software development, software engineering, okay, where you're learning by doing. You're learning in studios, working on projects. You're probably likely never to put a foot in a lecture hall if it is not for just, you know, attending a presentation by somebody else, okay? You're never going to have end-of-term exams because we are going to have a continuous assessment. Whatever you do is important. Whatever you do counts, like in the real profession. It is accelerated and intensive, so you get a master qualification in 4 years. You spend half of your time in companies being actually paid to work and solve on some really important problems in, you know, you see the names in the world's best companies. And half of your time you spend it learning with us, with the best lecturers and researchers that are actually professing this way, this new team-based integrated way of education. So if you look at the partners, I mean, this is the list of partners is still growing. So this is just a subset. We have just signed up 2 more companies last week. OK, you can see that the diversity in size, in dimensions, in local versus national versus international, OK, is very, very wide. that's important to us because we are completely aware of the fact that there are very different careers that you can pursue at the end of this course of studies. And so depending on whether you're more interested on in the software development per se, or whether you're interested to become a change agent, a developer in a specific domain, you have quite a choice. And we are going to have a good way of matching the students with the companies. There will be the opportunity of revisiting a company that you met in your early career, so to say, as a student in this course, maybe for your later residencies or for the master event. We are going to make sure that actually the companies know the students and the students know the companies. And that's why we don't have, an occasional relationship with the companies, but they are all signed up in a program that is called the Residency Partnership Membership Program. So these companies are with us. We know already now who are going to be the people that are going to mentor the students when the students are going to join them. We are discussing with them the contents of those blocks, of those modules, which are fully graded modules. Okay, that's also different from the typical co-op or internship placement model, so that you are with us, but there, okay, all the time. Does it is it worth, so to say, investing in software engineering? Well, we believe the numbers. The numbers are basically these ones. Look at the statistics here. Look at how much people are paid when they start. Starting salary at the year one of joining the profession in the median value, so to say, and then after 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, in various highly sought for careers. Okay, you could be a professional. You could have professional practice exams that you have to take, for example, or you could have different maturation tracks in the different professions. For example, in medicine, okay, take this one. You start with an internship year, then you become a resident, then you have to go to a supervised general practice, and finally you're a GP. Okay, and the same, so to say, for other other careers in law or in accountancy, etc. But you see that already at the starting point, and in particular, if you look at the situation after a couple of years or 5 years, which is early mid career, okay, you're going to see quite a difference in the pay. Not only because there is a really dear there is a lack of software engineers, skilled software engineers, like you're going to be, but also because software engineers are portable. They can work anywhere in the world. You can have your degree. Your degree will be recognized anywhere in the world. You will be able to actually practice wherever you want to go, wherever your family needs, wherever you have the wish to move. That's not the same in many other careers that are, of course, very important and very sought for, but they are basically tied to the accreditation or to some kind of professional limitations, so to say, to a specific jurisdiction. For example, I mean, if you are a doctor somewhere else, and not necessarily you can practice here. If you're an accountant in Ireland, you not necessarily can practice accountancy in Germany. If you're a teacher, you cannot necessarily be recognized elsewhere unless you have some conversion programs or some other recognition, so to say, procedures. The good and bad of software engineering is that it is very portable, and therefore you are basically assured that you can have very good and very interesting work experiences anywhere in the world. So what are the entry requirements? So what do you need to do in order to join? Well, you need to have a living certificate or an equivalent, okay, especially if you're coming from abroad, with the customary levels, so to say a minimum of 2 H5, 4 O6 or 4 H7 grades. The important one is the H4 in mathematics. We are going to have quite a lot of mathematics embedded into the modules. You're always going to meet mathematics where you need it, where it makes sense to you. This is going to be a huge help in making sense of what this mathematics, what these concepts, so to say, are used for and useful for. because you're going to meet them where you need actually to apply them, instead of having them as a distinct, separate subject that you learn typically in the first years, and then you may or may not apply later on. Okay. So the H4 is important. If you don't have, if you don't reach H4, or if you don't go for H grades, there is a special mathematics examination in UL every August. So you can have a second chance this way of, meeting this requirement. Okay. And additionally to this, you're going to have a portfolio submission. So after the CAO, when you have applied through the CAO, after that, we are going to send you information on how to upload your portfolio, okay? This is described on the website. We can go through that in a minute, okay, if you want. There is a description. It contains two parts. One is basically the description of a project that has to do something with technology, not necessarily a coding project that you have done, with all the motivation, why you did it, how you did it, why did you choose this particular solution, what is the impact that you achieved with having done this project for yourself and for others, maybe. And there is quite a wide range of suggested topics and suggested ways of putting together the portfolio. And on top of that, there is a little bit of a written statement, a motivation statement, in order to get to know something about you, that we should know, okay, in order to showcase that you are really the right person to join ISE and be happy and thrive in this way of education. Not everybody may be happy with this way. It is quite intensive, okay? So if you can have a fantastic education also in other courses. For people that like to work in groups, that like to take responsibility also for what they are learning, people with creativity, with engagement, that are that like to ask why and how, okay? That's the right course for them. And that's basically what we want to assess through this text that we are having with you. And there may be an interview, okay, following this. So this is basically all I wanted to say right now. I would open to the question and answers, and we can come back to the slides if necessary, or we can also look at the website if necessary. Okay. I stop sharing now. And we come back live. Okay, so let's see. So the way to discuss with each other is basically by Q&A. Let's see what the Q&A is saying. Okay, just go top down what is there. Jessica, what jobs can I get as a software engineer? Oh, a gazillion of opportunities. So even if software engineering is necessarily, related to technology, and you are going to learn how to code, you are going to learn how to problem solve, etc., that's definitely going to be the case. A lot of careers that started with a software engineering degree, they don't do necessarily production of code. For example, being product owner for a project. Basically, or a product in a company, okay? Basically, okay, going to the customers and finding out what they need, and already having an idea of what is the kind of software solution that could be behind that is a huge help, instead of just, you know, having no knowledge in IT and going to the customers and coming back with feedback and with requirements, and then having this to have to be translated into the vocabulary of technology, okay? So that's a non-coding job that is highly paid, highly sought for, highly critical, okay, for a company and for the users, okay, for the customers of the company. And it is, definitely not a coding job. Of course, there are the coding jobs, okay, in all the technology. If you look at the internet, if you look at mobile application, if you look at the drones, if you look at transportation, but also health, but also education, also all the other STEM areas and non-STEM areas, even in the arts, creative digital installations, etc., they use increasingly more IT and technology and software. Being able actually to deal with this in a professional way, that's a big advantage also for occupations that are not primarily coding. if you're going to go in a career, very few companies, large companies, they have a complete career progression in technical domains. A lot of companies at some point move yourself in the management domain. So it is not said that you will have to code for the entire time of your career. A lot of times people that are really, really strong technological people, they become mentors and project leaders and big leaders, so to say, of groups, but don't code themselves anymore. Okay, so this is just in order for the progression. The areas, well, you can become an employee, of course, of one of the big or small or medium companies. So that's obvious. You're going to have plenty of experience, okay, of how it feels like in your internships. But a number of the companies that we have, you're going to meet the founders. So you could become a founder yourself. Come up with an idea, an opportunity that you see, and basically create your own company. Maybe, you know, end up with your own unicorn at some point. You could have a very strong, you know, passion for helping others. Maybe also in professions that have to do with the public sector, with the government and so on. You won't believe it, but there is a lot of technical revolution that is happening at a local level, at a national level, at the international level that has to do with IT. And so there are increasingly many fantastic opportunities of being a game changer also in governmental, non-governmental and charities as well, so to say, in this sector. And then, of course, I mean, I mentioned it before, there is research, okay? You're going to be fantastically qualified to continue with a PhD, okay? We graduated just yesterday, my very first PhD students in UL. He's one of the young advisory board members of ISE. You can see a little bit about him on the webpage, Frederick Gossen. You can be a game changer also in research, either in one of the research centers that we have here in UL, you know, Liro or Confirm or several others, or maybe also abroad. Okay.
Tiziana, sorry to interrupt there. There's
more questions.
Over 25, 28 questions.
Okay,
there.
Okay. I will be fast. Okay.
Left if you want to have a run through. Okay, thanks.
Yes. Okay. Where is the description of the portfolio? The description of the portfolio is online. You go to the course details and then there is a portfolio and you find the PDF with exactly the description of this. How long will placement? Okay, Gary, is accommodation provided when working away from the university for placement, or will we need to budget for lodging, etc.? Well, like for all the internships and all the co-ops, so to say, you have to need to budget. Okay, we are looking with some companies for some solutions, etc. But in principle, it's on your side. How long will placement be for in each academic year? I just showed it. Okay, so you see the semesters, you see the blocks. Okay. Sometimes we start a little bit early and we finish a little bit late, but that's basically the structure. Will students need to move back and forth between their placement location and the university? Will they need accommodation in both locations? No, normally you are either on campus or you are in the company. Okay, there may be some situations that are remote. Okay, but that's a different situation. I think the students are paid when on placements. Yes. It is not now much, no, but of course, minimum wage is the minimum. Really just want to understand for budgeting purpose, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah, so that's, I mean, you can imagine more or less like a co-op, okay? Is there any reserved seat for people on here and there access routes? So we are very much into EDI, so equality, diversity, and inclusion. So the here and there access routes, of course, are important. You will have to apply according to that. We have reserved seats, I think, only for mature students, about 15%. So in the first year, we are going to have 25 students, so about four, okay? If we don't cover them, they will go back to the normal pool. We are going to accept other students that are not mature students, but here and there are absolutely welcome in UL. UL is an access university, so we support that. When is the deadline for the portfolio? That's on the description for the portfolio. It depends on when you are going to apply for the CAO. Okay, so when you apply for the CAO, after that, we are going to send you a link and there is going to be a deadline relatively to that for the portfolio. What do you mean there are no exams? Yeah, that means exactly what I say. You're not going to have, you know, a full semester, 12 weeks of education, and then there are 5 exams waiting for you all at once in 2 weeks. We are going to have continuous assessment. So every time that you do something, there is going to be a part of the grade that is matured this way. It is not really such a new things right now. During the COVID time, we have moved many other modules, so to say, to this assessment way. And so we have it actually experience in this quite a lot. Will placement be international, or will they only be in companies in Ireland? Yes. Okay, so that's the typical answer to an OR question by a computer scientist. It means yes, the one or the other. We will have most of the placements in Ireland, but many companies have already said that they are international, that they will offer international placements. How many places are on this course? This first intake is going to be 25 students, more or less. We are going to raise it in the next years to about 50 in the second year, and then plateau at around 75-80, just because working in groups, etc., it is so intensive in mentoring that we cannot deal with larger groups. Where is the studio in relation to the campus student accommodation? So the studio is on campus, we have the IBC2 building, two-thirds of the IBC2 building. So it is between the Tierney building, where Leo is located, the CSIS building, and the Schumann and KBS building. So it is on campus, and there is accommodation on campus. Are there any criteria or rubric that you will be using to assess portfolio? We have given criteria, so the criteria, you can read them basically already from the way we have formulated the question and the suggestions. So if you basically follow that, you're going to score well. How many people will be admitted this year? Around 25. Is the Living Cert computer science or technology project suitable for the portfolio? Well, actually, it should be something that you have done on your own. Okay, something else. Not necessarily the curricular thing, otherwise we are going to get the same from everybody. That's not going to be special to you. Okay. Is there any focus on sustainable development goals in the programs? Yes, massively. Already, I mean, the kind of low-code model-driven development that we are also going to meet in the course of the program is addressing 3 of the SDGs. With the companies, we are explicitly also going through the sustainable development goals, how they are, what is the focus on them in the companies, in the individual companies, and how they map into the projects that they are going to share with the students. Is there any focus? Okay, we had that. Does the residency work have a fixed pay irrespective of which company you work with? No. So every company will have their own policies and their own way of dealing with this. What we can assure is that you are going to be paid and that you are going to be able to survive. Okay, it's good. Okay, so it's not, there is no exploitation from that point of view, but there is no minimum, there is no, that's free to be discussed with the companies. The portfolio is worth 300 points and this will be added to the LC point. Correct, yes. Does this mean that if you don't do too well in the portfolio but still get good LC reported, you're good? Yes, but, okay, so we expect this to be quite competitive. So if you come at 300, 400 or whatever in the Living Cert, even with 300 on top, you don't have really, you know, the head start, okay, for this application. So try to do the best you can, okay, in the time that you still have to the final exams, so that you can have a balanced, let's say, evaluation. Do you recommend learning some coding before the course? And if so, what languages do you recommend? So it is not necessary. A lot of people I know that they are doing it. The language is not important to a large extent because you're going to learn or to use many languages. You're going to become a polyglot in a certain sense. What is important for us is the concept of programming, the mentality that comes with that. And so whatever you learn, if you learn already something, that's fine. If you don't know how to program, we are going to teach you. We are here for this. If you don't meet the H4 requirement, what will be on campus exam contain? Will it be similar to the Living Cert? Well, there you would have to ask the people that have more knowledge than me about the H4. We are trying to assess this way, so to say, similar things. Okay, it is in particular useful for people who chose to do only O levels. Okay, and they are learning the rest on their own, and this way they are able to ramp up, so to say, to that level. The portfolio is work. Okay, that's we already had that. Would a Living Cert engineering project be suitable for the portfolio? In principle, yes, but again, if it is Living Cert, you have already been rewarded for that, and it is it has been, how could I say, created for a different kind of criteria. Okay, so we will have to see. Okay, so yeah, we are going to hold actually a seminar on the portfolio, I think on the 25th of November, and if you go to the website, okay, which is ISE, it is software minus or dash engineering.ie, okay, and you go into contact, you can ask actually to be added to the mailing list for us, and with this you will get all this information. Okay, yeah, please email your questions that we did not get to. So thank you very much, everybody. Okay, this was a quick summary. See you online. Bye bye.